would like to try and explain how I'm going about doing what I do. As many of you know, this probably is my last year. So I'm kind of pulling back the curtains and showing you guys some of my secrets. Some of you may have noticed that I've got games up that didn't turn out in real life the way the simulations that I put up came out. In other words, there were wins and losses, and some of them were correct and some of them were not. Most of them were not. That's the nature of computerized simulations. So I wanted to kind of explain it. What I'll do is I'll go in and I'll show you. Whenever you're presenting a tournament of any type, what you want to do is you want to give the viewer the most realistic experience as possible. I kind of said earlier when I first started the tournament that I wasn't going to revisit games and try and plug in new results or new schedules. But the more I thought about it, the more that would have been not in keeping with what my station really is. And it is basically a station that produces simulations of sporting events. We try and stay true to them. We don't always get it right. Most of the time we don't get it right. And we're lucky if we get it right 50% of the time. So I kind of want to show you how I do all that. I think I've hinted at it before, but I never really showed you. So we're in the Sweet 16 now. So you have to say to yourself, how did he get the games to line up like the actual Sweet 16 when he's got games up that didn't reflect the wins and losses that would have created the Sweet 16? Well, it's very simple. I created my own server. What do I mean by that? Well, what I mean is I can, like if you go on NBA 2K21, and you go to play now, and then you go to today's games, they list the games that are going to be played today. Now, even though you may play that game, once that game is completed and you go back to play now, that game is up again. You can play it again over and over and over and over. So once I learned that this is the developer's mentality as far as saving information is concerned, I decided to try and mirror that. So now what I have is I can start from the beginning of the tournament. I can start from the Sweet 16. I could start from the second round. I could do any of that if I want to. It involves a little work, but still and yet, I can do it. So you say, yeah. How do you do it? Okay, here we go, guys. First of all, I choose tournaments. And in tournaments, NCAA tournament. Then I load. As you can see, I have 5 different tournaments within the save here. The first one is Tournament 0, okay? Tournament 0 is that first simulation that you guys saw. The first one where I started putting up games. The first 64 teams, okay? It's still intact. I can go to it now. I'll show you. It's better to show you than to try and explain it because it takes up too much time trying to explain it. So I go in here, and it should be in the Sweet 16, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, see, it's going to be Tennessee versus Illinois in the Sweet 16, and Syracuse versus Clemson, which is far from the truth, right? So now, okay, I'm showing you this because I want you to understand. This is my version of the server. So I can go back and play that anytime I want. Okay? But in trying to keep it real, what I've done is I've created more simulations. And those simulations are, I'm doing a little, taking care of a little business there. Sorry about that. Those simulations are of the current events. So now, how do I do that? Okay, I'll show you. First of all, I'm going to show you kind of like out of sequence here. It's the same version. I go to tournaments, NCAA tournaments, low tournaments. Now I'm going to go down to four. Four is my original outline of the tournament, right? Okay. Why is this important to some of you? Because some of you want to be creators of simulations. You need to learn tricks, things that will help you retain your audience. These are considered ideas that will help you retain your audience. Okay, so now when this comes up, it's going to be the first 64 teams. You see where it says March 19th through 20th? Okay, blah, 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 blah. You know, it's going to be Illinois versus Drexel, Georgia Tech versus Loyola Chicago, on and on here, okay? Okay, so now, I'm going to go out again. I just wanted to show you that. But I have a third simulation that I do. Okay? So I quit. Go out. Hit go in. Tournament again. Load. And I go to tournament one. Now, this will be the Sweet 16. So as you can see, I can play around with it. When I save things, you can double save things, like that last one that I showed you, where it was the virgin version of the tournament, where all 64 teams are still able to participate. If you use that to create the Sweet 16, you just have to make sure you duplicate it again so that you always have that to go back to in case something goes awry or somebody wins that you didn't expect to win and you want to change the result. So now we're in the Sweet 16, okay? You'll see it. I'm sorry if you don't understand, but I'm trying to give you a visual so that you will. Okay, so now you see. It's going to be Oregon State versus Loyola in the Sweet 16. That's one of the first games. Okay. Now we're going to go from the South region. We're going to go. I'm trying to get it to go to. Unfortunately, I can't show you what I want to show you. I want to show you the. It won't let me. It goes here, and then it won't let me show you all the teams that are in the Sweet 16. So basically, with these saves on this particular game, you have to proceed with the first game. Then it'll take you to the next game, and that might be in another region. But that region won't show until you've actually played the first game. So I can't actually show you everybody, but you know Syracuse is going to be playing Houston. Oregon State is going to be playing Loyola. But see, I couldn't start with this game because it would simulate this game. So you always start with what it shows you first. And just to to give you an idea, here's how it would go. I would go like this, and then I would say play. Then it's going to ask me to save. You don't save. You say no. Then you say, do you want to cancel this operation? Yes. But it'll show you the game. See? So then you can proceed from here. You can do a CPU versus CPU, or you can do a, you could actually play the game with either this team or that team. You see what I'm saying? It depends on your preferences as far as gameplay is concerned. I like to do CPU. Okay? So, this is basically how come you see so many different games up, guys. I know a lot of you are saying, how does he do that? Well, so you can see that I don't save this. I might go into this and see, it's going to ask me, do I want to save? If I save it, then this game will be whatever it's going to be, and I can't come revisit it. You see what I'm saying? So I avoid that by saying no. And then I cancel the operation, but it shows me the game. And I can do that with every game, even after I play this game. I do that with the next game. And since I didn't save it, I can exit and return to what? Oregon State versus Loyola Chicago, even though I might play 5 or 6 games. Okay. Some of you, I know I lost you. But for those of you who are trying to learn how to do simulations, you can do this with NBA 2K games. You can do this with Madden. You can do this with MLB Baseball. Though I will say this. NBA 2K is advanced more than, and so has Madden, actually. They have advanced in that they allow you to force simulate games if you want. You can force a team to win. Like if I wanted Loyola to win, I could force them to win in NBA 2K. The older games don't give you that luxury, so that's why you use the system that I use. So I didn't want this to be too long, but I didn't want it to be too short either. But I wanted to explain to you how I came up with the Sweet 16. Because I'm getting ready to start doing Sweet 16 games. And you're going to say, wait a minute. He has Loyola losing to Illinois. Yeah, I did. But the real simulation is the now. People are looking for the present. As I stated, and I will do it, I will finish the original simulation, which was this. And then I'm going to leave you on that. Just want to show you the razzle-dazzle here. Zero is the original simulation where all of the simulations went differently than real life. But we didn't get to the Final Four, so we don't know how they're going to select the Final Four. We know Illinois and Tennessee shouldn't be in the Final Four. We know that Syracuse has a chance to be in the Final Four. But Clemson does not. So that's yet to be determined. And then the games in the other regions can't be determined until I do Tennessee and Illinois, as I explained earlier. Okay. So that's it, guys. I just wanted to give you a quick synopsis of how I do this, and that you can do it too. You just have to clone things. You have to know how many clones a game system will allow you to do. I think NBA 2K allows you 10 games you can save. You can save, or 10 different models of playoffs or whatever that you want to save. This game allows you 5. Plus, you can do a dynasty also. But I think you're limited to 1 dynasty if you got 5 tournament games up. So anyway, like I said, I just wanted to give you guys the lowdown on how this is done. And I'm doing the fancy footwork while I'm concluding here, just to show you once again the possibilities that you can have if you set it up this way. This is more for guys who have to have a YouTube channel than anybody else. This is a teachable moment. So I'm using it to teach you how to do this. So how did I arrive at this? The Sweet 16. Remember the first one that I showed you. File number 4. Tournament number 4. I set this Sweet 16 up by going in and simulating all the games until I got to the Sweet 16. Okay, guys, that's it. I didn't want to talk this long, but I did. Have a great day, and hopefully you'll enjoy what I put up. And I will continue that first simulation at some point, probably once the Final Four is selected or the championship game is selected. I'll revisit that, and I'll also revisit the Legends tournament, too, because I enjoy it, and I'm winding down, so this is on my bucket list of things to do. Thanks for being great viewers over the years. I really appreciate it. And maybe I can continue, but it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to do so at this time. Okay, guys? All right. Take care.